Welcome back to yet another Blu-ray unboxing. This time around, as you can see, I have not one, but two films to unbox for you. The films in question are parts 2 and 3 of the Outpost series. Spoiler, I purchased this one, Outpost Black Sun, not noticing the Black Sun under the title, as you probably won't either. I assumed this was the first one. I've never seen any of these that I'm aware of. If I have, I probably tried the first one, didn't like it, but whatever, I'm going to completely disregard the first one and just pretend in my viewing experience that this is parts 1 and 2 because, I mean, really, they're direct-to-video Nazi zombie films. I don't think I'm really missing that much with not having seen, at least in its entirety, the first entry. That being said, let's go ahead and take a look at the special features. Apparently you get one, a making of Outpost Black Sun. The film clocks in at 101 minutes. There's both a DVD and a Blu-ray copy. And the cast, pretty much, I'm pretty sure it's just all no one I've ever heard of. But what are you gonna do? Outpost 3, Rise of the Spetsnaz. Has even less special features. There's nothing on this disc at all. It is considerably shorter, clocking in at 87 minutes, so that instantly, in my mind, makes this the stronger of the two films. Again, I don't see any recognizable names in the cast or crew, so there you have it. Complete unknowns making a movie about an overly done topic. Let's go ahead and pop this first or second film open. This has got to be like the most brittle plastic on any Blu-ray or anything I've ever seen. This shrink wrap just, I don't know, it feels weird. Whatever. Damn stickers. There we go. Shredded that thing. There you can see there is a bit of difference between the two discs, something I'm always a fan of. I do not want to have to sit here and stare at both of them forever trying to discern which is which. You can clearly make out the Blu-ray has the zombies. The DVD has what I'm assuming is the soldiers battling the zombies. So pretty cool design choice there. I do enjoy that. Who knows, that could be the strongest element of this film. I don't know, I can't say that yet. I can't say, you'll have to stay tuned. But moving on, Outpost 3, or 2, however. It is kind of interesting that both were put out by separate crappy imprints of Accelerator Films, with Screamfest and Macabre here. Both are Accelerator, so whatever. I don't know if it's different people paying for the actual production or the rights to put the home video out, and honestly, I don't care. I really don't care. I picked both of these films up at my local Dollar Tree, so if you see this video in a timely fashion, you might too. This is only the Blu-ray. There's obviously no DVD included, and it's a pretty cool-looking Blu-ray. I gotta say, that's some pretty cool artwork. I don't think that artwork, oh, it is on the back. I was going to say, I don't think they reused that artwork anywhere else, but they totally did, and I am totally wrong. But there you have it, Outpost 1 and 2, or 2 and 3 if you're a dick, unboxed for your enjoyment.